All of the complex calculations your computer performs can be broken down into a sequence of simple mathematical operations. Computers are constantly adding numbers, multiplying numbers, comparing numbers, moving numbers from place to place, and more to calculate answers to problems. For that to be practical, computers need to be able to perform these operations quickly. So, to take one of these operations, how do computers add numbers? And how can they do so fast enough to solve complex problems efficiently? The basic strategy is not all that different from how people add numbers. If you are given two numbers to add, you probably add them a pair of digits at a time. Add the first pair of digits, then the next pair, and so on. Sometimes you might add a pair of digits and be left with a carry that then affects the addition of the next pair of digits. Computers do the same thing, just with binary bits instead of decimal digits. A circuit called a full adder adds together two bits, plus a possible carry bit. It then produces a sum and a possible carry of its own. For example, if we add together a 1 and a 0 with an input carry bit of 0, then the sum will just be a 1 with no output carry. But if we add together a 1 and a 0 with a carry bit of 1, that changes the calculation. Now we output a carry of 1, and the sum bit is 0. These full adders perform very simple operations on bits, but we can combine them to add larger numbers. To add two 4-bit numbers together, we can chain together 4 full adders into a ripple carry adder. The first full adder adds the rightmost bits and produces a sum. It also passes on a carry bit to the next full adder, which computes a sum and passes on a possible carry bit to the adder after that. By chaining together enough of these single bit adders, we can design circuits that add numbers as large as we'd like. But as the numbers we add get larger, you'll notice that the addition takes longer and longer. And most of the adders are spending most of their time waiting to be handed their carry bit so that they can start calculating. But this is not a very efficient use of time. Ideally, all of these adders would love to start computing their sums right away, but they can't because their sums depend on whether there's a carry coming in from the previous adder. This is where carry-lookahead logic can help. In a carry-lookahead adder, the basic idea is to add logic that calculates all of the carries quickly and at the same time, and then passes them on to the adders that need them. That lets the individual single-bit adders do their work without needing to wait for all of the previous adders. But how does that work? How can this carry-lookahead adder know what all of the carries will be without actually doing the whole addition? To answer that question, let's take a look at one of these single-bit adders and consider whether or not it will produce a carry. Depending on the input values, there are a couple things we might be able to say about this addition. For some input values, we might be able to say that the addition generates a carry. Generating a carry means that the addition will produce a carry regardless of whether or not there's an input carry. That would be the case if the two bits being added are both ones. When adding two ones, it doesn't matter whether there's an input carry or not. There will always be a carry output. So we say that this addition generates a carry. Stated more formally, if we're adding together two bits A and B, then we can say that the addition generates a carry if A and B are both one. For other input values, we might say that the addition propagates a carry. Propagating a carry means that if there's a carry input, then there will be a carry output. For example, if the input bits are a 1 and a 0, then this addition propagates a carry. If there's a carry input, then the output will have a carry too. But if the input bits are two zeros, then the addition does not propagate a carry. Even if there's a carry input, there will be no carry output. In other words, if we're adding together two bits A and B, then the addition propagates a carry if A or B are one. Thinking about these single-bit additions in terms of generating and propagating carries is useful for two reasons. First, for each pair of bits, we can calculate whether that addition generates or propagates a carry immediately, without waiting for the results of any other calculations. That means that right when the addition starts, we can calculate these generate and propagate values for all pairs of bits at the same time. Second, we can then use these generate and propagate values to compute all of the carries. For any given addition of a pair of digits, we can calculate the carry output this way. The addition will produce a carry of 1 if the addition generates a carry, or if there's a carry input and the addition propagates a carry. We can use this idea to get a formula for each carry in this 4-bit adder. Assuming we're adding just these 4-bit numbers without any carry coming into them, the carry output from the first addition is just equal to whether or not that addition generates a carry. The carry output of the second addition is 1 if the second addition generates a carry, or if the first addition generates a carry, and the second addition propagates that carry. The carry output of the third addition is 1 if the third addition generates a carry, or if the second addition generates a carry that the third addition propagates, or if the first addition generates a carry that both the second and the third additions propagate. Maybe you can see a pattern forming here. We can construct a similar formula for the carry output of the fourth addition. Notice that all of these formulas are calculated just based on the generate and propagate values, which are values we know we can calculate quickly and at the same time. The formulas themselves can also be calculated quickly too. It takes one logical step to AND together these individual terms in the formula, and then a second step to OR the terms together to get the carry values. The result is that when adding these two 4-bit numbers, while the first pair of bits is being added together, we can compute propagate and generate values and start combining them. This results in all of the carry values, which can then be passed to all of the other single-bit adders so that they can do their work simultaneously. Theoretically, as the numbers we're adding get larger, the time saved by this carry-lookahead logic gets even greater. In a traditional ripple carry adder, adding larger numbers would mean more waiting as the carries get passed from one adder to the next. But in a carry-lookahead adder, we could compute all the carries all at once. In practice, though, the formulas for computing the later carries get large with lots of terms, and it's no longer so practical to build circuits that can calculate them in just two steps. Instead, what we'll often do is package together our logic for a 4-bit carry look-ahead adder and chain them together to make a larger adder. We could then let each 4-bit adder run one at a time, passing carries on to the next one. But of course, now we know a more efficient way to do this. We can use carry look-ahead logic again, just on a bigger scale. Each 4-bit group can now calculate a generate and propagate value for its group, and a larger carry look-ahead unit can use that information to compute the carries for each 4-bit adder so that they can do their work in parallel without waiting for each other. Applying carry look-ahead logic when adding large numbers saves a significant amount of time. When we're talking about circuits, that time is measured in nanoseconds, but when computers are performing billions of operations, those nanoseconds add up. Our logic is faster now by taking advantage of the fact that computer circuits can do multiple things at once. So by giving them multiple tasks they can perform, without needing to wait for other logic to complete first, we can make our calculations much more efficient.